So thanks everybody for coming. First of all, if you haven't been through the house, please make yourself at home. We always say you can take your shoes off, you can leave them on, but don't forget them when you leave. But I also like to say, I'm going to tell you a really interesting fact that no one even knows. I don't think you know this, but this entire home actually was built by Legos. I'm joking. But no, when Lego came to us, it was like a no-brainer. Our kids have been using them for, you know, oldest just turned 15, Wolfie. We've been using them for years. I used them for years. My siblings used them for years. So it was such an easy, something for us, partnership for us to get behind. They're amazing people. We really, really believe in the new product because, you know, not only design, but interiors, but like if you go to our bedroom, and that crazy looking desk, it looks like a shark. You know, that was designed by Zaha Hadid, who's probably the best architect in the world right now, an Iraqi female. We walked through Tribeca, Winka Doubledon, who's a close friend of mine, a Dutch architect, is considered, probably one of the best contemporary architects in the world. So it's not just about interiors, but it's about building, it's about creativity. It's about boys and girls. I come from a family of strong women, and I'm scared to say it. I'm worried the women are starting to take over the world. But I think it's a phenomenal, company. It's a phenomenal product. But as far as the kids go, we have 7 children that are all different in look, in size, in personality, and likes and dislikes. We see the highs and the lows. As parents, we never say what we know. We say what we've learned. And what we've learned is kids love creativity. Our job is not, our job is to expose them to music, to art, to design, to sports, and let them kind of figure out what they like. And at the end of the day, we'll help them get there. So when we design a room for a child, it's really, all our kids share a room, and Cortney and I actually even share a space. But it's giving them their own unique space, a workspace. It could be a small. We did a bedroom in a Hell's Kitchen for triplets, a 200 square foot bedroom, and the kids had toys all over the place. And we said, let's get rid of all the toys. We don't need all the clutter. Get rid of that, and then give you something of your own, your own little creative space that you can dream. You can imagine, you can build, I grew up with 7 kids, 1 bathroom, so, middle class kids, so it's not about how big your house is or how small your house is, but everybody needs their own little world, and so we try to do that with the kids. I think Lego is doing an amazing job letting kids dream.
Yeah, I mean, I love the idea of this kind of Lego Friends and the research they did, because we have 5 boys, 2 girls. And if I could have something like the Lego bricks to keep my daughters young, because girls kind of, that creative play doesn't exist as long as it does for boys. And so they're 13 now. They still will take Legos, which was given to us today, which was amazing. And they start building and designing, and maybe they'll work for us one day. Who knows? Maybe they'll love interior decorating or becoming an architect. But that whole idea that girls and boys now can really take the Lego bricks and really create and play and design and take it a step further. Now, I know my 5 boys, we're not going to keep this chair because they will probably break it and then build something else where the girls would notice the detail on it and appreciate it. But I think that whole kind of research study is pretty amazing that they took the time to do that, which helps us in our life. I'm constantly looking at birthday presents to give all the number of birthday parties that we get invited to. And it's nice that I can now go to Lego for both sexes, and which is really important. And it's a quality product, which is cool. But as far as design tips that hopefully, we could build with our Lego bricks that are here, the workspace that my husband spoke about, not all of us are going to have a Lego desk. But it is important to have a desk, no matter how small it is, so your kids can, our 3-year-old sits and does Lego bricks or colors. My son Wolfie, that's 15, does laptop homework, but we all need that space. And then as far as like storage, if we have quality things for the kids to hang out with and learn and play and grow with, instead of like all this stuff, if we have storage units where they can put all the pastel Legos away in, you know, and really tidy up their space is pretty important. And then also to, I push that we don't live like we used to, where like the living room was the best part of the house and all the best art was in the living room and, you know, the kids' rooms were kind of like whatever. Now every piece of art should be throughout your house. That makes us, Robert and I, want to hang out in our kids' rooms more. So I think decorating's come a long way, which is exciting, you know. So fine art to your kids' art to a flea market portrait should go throughout your entire house. But what's most important is you guys hopefully have seen our house tonight, so maybe you know us a little bit better. But I expect to get invited to your house, so I can understand who you guys are. It really should be a reflection of who you are when it comes to decorating. So anyway, I thank you so much for coming
tonight.
Thanks, guys. Thank you.